was released recently, Magento Quality Patches. The speaker is Viktor Tymchynskyi, our senior software engineer. Okay, so Viktor.
Thanks, Nadia.
Are you ready?
Hi, guys. My name is Viktor. I'm software engineer from Magento support department. And today I'll talk about a new tool, Magento Quality Patches. It's a self-service tool that allows you apply, revert, and view a general information about patches released by Magento support team. I'm pretty sure that you are familiar with Magento Cloud Patches package. Magento Quality Patches, basically, it's an extension for Magento Cloud Patches. Cloud Patches delivers only a small amount of the most critical fixes, and all these fixes are required to be applied on your cloud instance. Quality Patches contains a much bigger amount of different quality fixes, and all of them are optional. Basically, we recommend apply them only on case-by-case basis, only the patches that you need. So I prepared a short screencast to demonstrate this tool, and after the screencast, I will answer for your questions. So let me start. Are you able to see my screen?
Yes.
Okay. Hello and welcome to the short demo of the Magento Quality Patches tool. I will be covering what Magento Quality Patches is, how it can be installed and used by our customers. Magento Quality Patches tool is a composer package that contains a set of patches and commands for working with them. It's intended to automate distribution of quality patches across cloud and on-prem Magento customers. The general flow looks next. Support team creates a patch and pushes it into MQP repository. As soon as the next version of the MQP Composer package is published, the patch becomes available to cloud and on-prem customers. Customer installs or updates MQP Composer dependency and gets the latest patches compatible with his Magento version. Customer selects and applies patches that are needed for solving his issues. Let's take a look how it can work for on-prem Magento customer. Imagine that I am happy owner of fresh installed fancy Magento store. Everything is going well until one day I face several core issues. For demo purpose, I'll add some issues to instance. So, I have three issues and I'm not happy anymore. I'm calling to Magento support and asking for help. Support tells me, "Hey, Viktor, we are happy to inform you that your issues are known and there is a Magento Quality Patches tool that will help you to fix them." If you are on-prem customer, then you should require MQP Composer package using a command. Composer require Magento Quality Patches. If you are a cloud customer, just update Magento ECE tools and you will be all set. Okay, let's try. I'll make a small modifications in the command to get a demo package. Need to wait for a while until Composer updates the dependencies. It can be not so fast. And here we go. Now we have Magento patches script located in vendor bin folder. This script provides next commands. Status shows a list of available patches. Apply performs patch applying, and revert performs patch reverting. Let's check the list of available patches with status command. We see the table with next information. Page ID. ID is the same as Jira issue number. Page title. Short title of the page. Type. For on-prem, all patches are optional. For cloud, some patches can be required. Status. Can be applied, not applied, or not available. When we can't identify status due to some conflicts. And details. Contains the list of affected components such information like required patches. We need this feature to solve possible compatibility conflicts. So, as customer, I see that page MC1 fixes issue 1, page MC2 fixes issue 2, and page MC3 fixes issue 3. It's a good news for me because I have all these issues on my instance. Let's apply a first page. We see a message that a page has been successfully applied. And let's check a status table. We see that MC1 page has applied status. Let's refresh our instance. And we see that issue 1 was gone and was fixed by page MC1. Page MC1 works. If I change my mind and want to come back issue 1, I can revert the page MC1. Let's do it. We see a message that page FC1 has been reverted successfully. Let's check a status table. We see that page FC1 has not applied status. And after refreshing the page, we see issue 1 is on a place. Now I want to apply two patches at once to fix both issue 1 and issue 2. Let's do it. We see that both patches has been applied successfully. Let's check status table. Patches MC1 and MC2 have applied status. And after refreshing the page, we see both issues fixed. Now I changed my mind again and want to revert all applied patches. I can do it with command option all. revert, and option all. Let's check a status table. Now you can see that all patches have not applied status. And let's refresh the page. After refreshing the page, all issues again may cause troubles. Next case will be applying a patch that has dependency on other page. It's a patch MC3. As you can see, it requires MC2. The reason of dependency can be modification the same lines of code by both patches. Let's apply it. Tool tells me that patch MC2 is required for MC3 and asks confirmation to apply it as well. I give my confirmation, and here we go. Both patches are applied. Let's check our page. As you can see, issue 2 and issue 3 were fixed, and the page MC3 and MC2, I changed the same line of code. And the last case I would like to demonstrate you, it's a patch replacement. Imagine that support wants to replace page MC3 with some improved version MC3 version 2. For demo purpose, I'll do it in a patch configuration directly on instance. Let's check a status table. Here we can see recommendation to replace MC3 with MC3 version 2. And we see that MC3 has type deprecated now. Let's do it. Why? MC3 version 2. The tool asks confirmation to revert deprecated page and applies a new one. Let's check status table again. Now you see that deprecated page MC3 disappeared from status table at all. So it's not available anymore. Let's check our page. And we see issue 3 was fixed by a new page, MC3 version 2. That were the main features of Magento Quality Patches tool. There are some differences of usage for cloud customers. Before applying selected quality patches, the set of required cloud patches is applied automatically. It shouldn't make any trouble since all optional quality patches are compatible with required cloud patches. And since cloud has a read-only file system, patches are applied during the deployment process by ECE tools. So a customer needs to set the list of patches as environment variable in Magento env YAML file and commit the changes. It looks like that. We open Magento env YAML file and add the list of desired patches here, quality patches. And commit and push changes into the remote branch. After that, the process of redeploy will be started and applied all the patches on cloud instance. I hope this demo was informative enough. If you have any further questions, feel free to reach out to me. Thanks for watching. There are a lot of questions here. Let me delete them. Thanks, Skip, for replying on that.
Victor, you want to take the last one about why we took this approach?
Give me a minute to read. How does patch apply works? Does it work with Composer, or we would need to apply patch directly on live instances? I'm trying to understand how the patch would move from one end to another. As you can see in the presentation, you should add in Magento env YAML configuration variable quality patches and just list the ID of patches that you want to apply from this package. And that's it. Is it the answer for your question?
Yeah, there is also a question why it's still kind of manual on cloud, even though, and not the same way as like required quality patches.
On cloud, why don't we use same way cloud patches works today with Composer?
I mean, I can try to answer this because it was pretty much a product decision. So essentially the idea of quality patches is that it's a set of patches which our support team develops, and previously they were sending those via Zendesk or emails or wherever other mechanisms were to share those patches with customers and partners. So right now essentially they stop doing that and they send all of those into a Composer package, which is Magento Quality Patches. The benefit of it is that Magento Quality Patches is guaranteed to work with cloud. It has no conflicts. It knows about all the required cloud patches applied, and it works also against cloud specific modified code, meaning not only like the plain core code, but also all the cloud patches we apply. So now you can be sure that all the quality patches bundled through this package are 100% compatible with cloud. And it's a huge benefit because previously we've observed issues when actually, you know, some patches were sent and they were not working with modified cloud code. It's first. Second, why we don't do it the same way as like regular cloud patches, mainly because regular cloud patches are either something that is required for cloud, so, you know, to power some functionality which doesn't work otherwise, for example, for previous older versions, or those are some kind of P0 issues which have to be covered and updated for everyone. So mainly those which are published officially on magento.com. Quality patches, on the other hand, is a list of optional improvements or fixes for specific issues. So unless you really have that issue and it affects anything you are doing, you don't really need or want to patch it. Because at some point there will be hundreds of those patches in Magento Quality Patches, and you don't really want to apply all the hundreds of patches to your implementation and destabilize it this way, kind of. So you apply pretty much what you need to, and you still have an option to do, as Viktor said, to apply everything, but I don't think it's a viable approach to apply everything unless you really need it. So that's why we didn't force the installation of all the patches which are bundled there. And,
Next question, why don't create a different YAML that is read and implemented? We use existing Magento and YAML since we need to know on build phase which patches should be applied, and it fits in a concept of existing Magento and YAML configuration. Why do you need a different YAML? What is the purpose to have a different YAML? So basically, if we, this is a question about on-prem, how to distribute the same configuration for these patches across several on-prem instances, you also can use Magento app and YAML file, Magento and YAML file for that purpose. But basically, on-prem instance, you can apply these patches the same as on cloud, but the command will be a little bit different. It will be not Magento patches, but ECE patches. ECE patches read configuration from Magento and YAML even without ECE tools, and it can be used for on-prem instances as well. As I said, one minute, I'll send the links on the documentation. Copy a link. 1 minute. So I send the link on documentation how it can be configured for cloud. As I said, for on-prem, you can use the same model. You can put quality patches, you can create Magento and YAML, put the quality patches variable, and list patches that you need, you want to be required on your on-prem instance. And just copy this YAML file across your on-prem instances. And then you should use ECE patches apply command, not Magento patches, but ECE patches apply. And this command will read this configuration, will apply required cloud patches, then will apply this quality patches, and then patches from M2 hotfixes folder as it works for cloud. Will it help? I'll share documentation. Here you can find information how to add this variable to Magento and YAML and to apply the patches. You should run this command. PC patches apply. This command will read Magento and YAML even on on-prem instances. Okay, I hope it will help you. So, other questions?
Okay, if no more questions, thank you, Viktor. Thank you for your presentation. And as usual, we will publish this record in our Spark page. And if you will have questions later, please ask them in our Community Cloud Slack channel. And Viktor is also there, and we will be able to answer them. Thank you very much.
Sorry, Nadia. If I'm there, I'm not sure. Can you check and add
I will
me?
Add you.
Okay.
Yeah, I will
and, check. Yeah, you guys in this channel links on available documentation for cloud, for on-prem, and I will be glad to answer your questions, further questions, your concerns. Please write your concerns in this channel and. We will discuss and maybe implement some additional features if you need them. Okay. So thanks guys for your attention.
Thanks everyone.
See you. Yeah, bye.